charming poet here. Please, please make a rousing round of applause for Andrea.
Hi, I'm Andrea. I've got a couple of poems today. I've got four actually, and I've never done that many, so be nice to me. The first one is called Skipping Stones Along the Train Tracks. I show up to every poem with an empty backpack. Loose straps and tight buckles bruising my knees. We, children of the tide, our legs made of seafoam. We keep returning in new wellies, two sizes too big, again and again. Until one day we don't, stuck on a train in Istanbul or a ferry in Sicilia, and all that is left are the stones that we turned if we threw them in the ocean. Shipwreck dreams stuck in the tips of our shores. This next one is the next one is called I'm Building a Home, and it's a reaction to how everyone, like all my friends back home, are starting to get married and have children and get houses, and I'm like, no. I'm building a home on Tuesday's laundry and broken light bulbs. I spent so long balancing on top of the pile of return to center confidence. I toppled over and hit my head. I'll clean the place up before you come over, I swear. Do you want to stay the night? I can make a bed for you. Just remember to beat out yesterday's daydreams before you go to sleep. They like to keep people awake, you see. And if you want a cup of tea, I make an okay ginger and lemon. But please excuse me for a second, ambitions keep dusting up the bottom of my mugs. If you do come around, I'll welcome you with a marching band's drum roll to my fault of dirty dishes and expired parking tickets. Just don't expect too much from me. When you arrive in the shirt, your wife neatly ironed with a briefcase full of documents and signatures. I'm still trying to divide my socks from my spoons from my groceries. And I'm doing my best.
Yeah!
This one doesn't have a name, but you know, like when you're walking past churches and music comes out of them, and it's all very weird, also that wonky? Yeah. The sound of a piano woken from slumber trickles out into the cold October night. As the street lights catch on the poor man's Bible and the smell of candle wax intertwined with the dust of prayers past. A man sits just inside the door, clasping frozen blue fingers, torn nails, desperate to be nothing but part of the architecture. The pitter-patter of impatient feet still echo through the aisle, followed close by white veils and heavy shoes. God may not wait on these walls, but all of our stories do.
Nice.
This is my last one, it's one of my first ones. It's my favourite, but it's just it's not because it's really good, but it's just because it was the first one I ever dared to like do on poetry platform.
Woo!
And it's called Cake.
Yeah!
The first English word I learned was cake. Whether that says more about me or about the Norwegian educational system, I don't know. But I can still remember words printed in primary colours and pinned on walls. Apple, boy, cake. Then came the scarier words. Hope, truth, imagination. Until one day I learned love. And I learned that English people love everything. You love pizza. And you love your friends. You love that new TV series. And you love your girlfriend. And in the beginning I found it strange, because back home, we never say that we love anything. We like things and we're fond of people. And of course we have a word for that feeling when someone has been your whole world, ever since that world was small enough to fit into the bottom of a bunk bed. But to say that you love someone. So I wasn't used to it. I acted strange around it. I didn't want to say that I loved anything, because how can you use such a big word as love for something as small as cake? But then I moved here and something changed. That's not how love works, you said. That's not how your heart works. Loving one thing doesn't mean loving something else less. And loving one person doesn't mean that you can't love another. And when you ask, did it become a bad thing to love a lot? So I stopped being so afraid of the word. Now? Now I love pizza. And I love that new TV series, and I love cake. I love you.